A traveler in time, you fight for goodness.
What happens when a European company hires Lou Scheimer and Filmation to make a cartoon based on a popular comic character? You get this. Yeah, Sport Billy. Well, I'm sure no one in America has heard of this character or this show. He seemed to be a big deal in Europe. He was a popular comic book character who was so popular he was used by FIFA as the fair play mascot for the FIFA World Cups. So yeah, definitely kind of a big deal at one point. Such a big deal he needed a cartoon show, and a European company, Sport Billy Limited, decided not to do it in their country or outsource it to Japan like most European cartoons did at the time. No, they decided to license it out to Filmation, of all places. Why Filmation, you ask? That's a damn good question that I don't have a damn good answer for, sorry. Maybe Hanna-Barbera turned them down. I mean, that's what happened with He-Man. Regardless, this show was made for an European audience and it aired in a variety of countries in 1979. However, Lou Scheimer wasn't going to make a cartoon and not get some of those American buckaroos out of it, so Sport Billy ended up hitting the American shores in 1982, both on syndication and as part of a mid-season replacement show for NBC. So what is Sport Billy about, you may ask? Well, in this show, Sport Billy is from Olympus, a twin Earth on the opposite side of the sun, filled with godlike athletes. In fact, you might ask, are these the Greek gods? And I'd say, heck, I don't know. Outside of Billy mentioning Zeus once,
this bow and arrow was given to me by Zeus.
I don't think any of the Greek gods are ever mentioned or seen. At least not in any of the episodes I've found, because finding episodes of this show isn't exactly easy. Anywho, Billy has decided to dedicate his life to spreading the message of good sportsmanship and fair play on Earth. Too bad he's not doing that now. I know a few politicians that could use a few lessons in good sportsmanship and fair play. Billy is good-natured, athletic, and heroic. He's also bland. Not sickeningly bland, but still bland. To aid him on his quest, though, Billy has his weird alarm clock-shaped spaceship that can travel through time and space, as well as his Omnisac. His Omnisac is probably one of the more interesting gimmicks in the show, as it's a size-changing gym bag that allows him to pull out various sports-related items that help him on his quest. Totally not ripped off of Felix the Cat.
I'd better use my little bag of tricks.
Well, every top athlete has his own little bag of tricks.
And since it's a Filmation cartoon, you can get used to seeing this animation a lot. And I do mean a lot. Billy is also voiced by Filmation co-founder Lou Scheimer's son, Lane Scheimer. Because, you know, nepotism. I mean, he sure didn't hire him for his acting. I mean, listen to this.
Thanks for the tips, Billy.
Just give it your best, Mark. We'll be there, cheering for you.
What kind of delivery is that? That's just, yeah, nepotism. Hired because of nepotism. I got nothing. Also, the voice just feels weird for Billy. It sounds like a 30-year-old man's voice coming out of, like, what, a child? Hate it. I really hate it. Lane Scheimer? More like Lame Scheimer, am I right? Well, Billy isn't going on his mission alone, though. He has two people aiding him on his quest, one of which is an Earth girl named Lily. Lily is friendly, nice, athletic, and also bland. They're a perfect match. She also helps pilot the spaceship at times, and she seems to really want to pet Billy's Willy. And by that, I mean their third partner, a talking dog named Willy. I don't know if Willy came from Earth or not, but considering he can talk, I'm going to guess no. And since he's a talking dog, you'll be right in guessing he's a comic relief character. Or at least he tries to be. I'm not sure if all the characters having rhyming names is coincidental, or if Billy just has some weird egotistical OCD disorder where he can only travel with companions that have names that rhyme with his. Also assisting the rhyming name squad is two Olympians named Sporticus and Pandusa. Wait, Sporticus? Man, he really let himself go after Lazy Town. I also hate his, what I'm assuming to be a beard. It looks less like a beard and more like he just has huge white razors coming out of his face. It's a really weird design. I don't like it. I just don't. Billy often reports to them and asks for advice, often with the aid of their Olympus computer that sometimes has an attitude problem.
Something is interfering with the sun's rays. speeding up the growth effects to the millionth power.
Ah, we know that. We know that.
Well, if you know so much, then let's see you answer the questions.
Wow, must run on a Mac OS. However, no show is complete without a villain, and Billy's main villain is Queen Vanda, the ruler of a planet called Vandalusa. She hates fairness and wishes to destroy all sports. A mission I can't say I'm 100% against, to be honest. Assisting her on her quest is her right-hand goon, a clumsy gnome named Sipe. She also has a weird asshole parrot that sometimes appears named Poco. Fortunately, it's not a raccoon, because then it could be Poem Poco, and, well, if you've ever seen that Ghibli film, I don't think that would have flied on network television. Since I mentioned Lane Scheimer voiced Billy, it should be worth mentioning that all the rest of the voices are supplied by three people, though only two of them are credited. All female voices in the show are provided by actress Joyce Bulifant, probably best known for her recurring role in the Mary Tyler Moore Show. Willie, Sipe, Poco, and a majority of the other male voices are provided by Frank Welker, because, you know, of course it is. I'm sure y'all are familiar with Mr. Welker by this point, but he is by far one of the most talented and prolific voice actors out there, playing more than 1,000 cartoon characters within his lifespan, which includes a majority of the cast of the original Transformers, but he's probably best known for playing the voice of Freddy Jones from Scooby-Doo for over 50 years now. I'm honestly surprised they didn't just get Frank to play Billy. His Fred voice would have sounded way more natural for him than the voice they chose, but again, nepotism. The final voice actor is Filmation co-founder Lou Scheimer himself, who goes uncredited. He mostly voices the computer systems in the show, but occasionally does a few incidental characters here and there. He has a habit of popping up in quite a few Filmation shows, usually with some sort of sound alteration added to his voice. The most popular example of this being Orko in He-Man or Swiftwind in She-Ra. With all this said, is Sports Billy a catastrophe? Well, let's take a look and find out. Also, I want to mention that this wasn't exactly the easiest show for me to find episodes of, so please forgive the quality in areas. I'm doing the best I can with what I've found. So the first episode we look at starts on Vandalusa, where Sipe uses the absolute worst elevator conceived in the history of cartoons. And it looks like all that broken glass won't stop him from telling Queen Vanda about the amazing thing he just accomplished.
I did it! I did it!
Sipe, did you do something?
Did I do something? Did I do something? Oh boy, did I do something?
Good. Are you going to tell me what you did?
Oh, of course, your delicious meanness.
What did you do? If you don't tell me what you did, I'm going to get a teeny, teeny, weeny bit angry!
So angry, she might reuse that animation a third time.
I got Sport Billy.
You got Sport Billy? Where? When?
That's a pretty good question. You look pretty empty-handed there, Sipe. Seems Billy is the honorary starter of the Oslo Regatta, but unknownst to Billy, Sipe has exchanged the flare in his starter's pistol with a special Vandalusan rocket, which ends up destroying all the ships at the event.
Wonderful! They'll blame all of this on Sport Billy. His name will be Hooligas Fool. That's Jinx in Norwegian.
Whoa, really? I wonder if anyone ever called Joel that.
That is not a good noise. It just isn't.
This is terrible.
It's worse than that. It's...
Yow!
You can say that again.
No thanks. I'd rather not.
I agree. It's yow doesn't make much sense to begin with. So Billy is blamed for the incident, but that won't stop him from opening the Viking exhibit in the museum tomorrow. However, Vanda and Sipe decide to continue their quest of making Billy look like a...
Hooligan fool! That's Jinx in Norwegian.
So Sipe sets up another dirty trick, this time setting up a trap that destroys the entire Viking selling exhibit when Billy cuts the ribbon opening it to the public. Not only does it destroy the entire exhibit, it does it with as little animation as possible.
You hoodoo.
Hoodoo voodoo? We do voodoo. And no, I'm not sponsored by voodoo, but we could be. Voodoo, message me. I'm sure I'll get you 1, 2, 3, 1 customer? Yeah, 1 good customer. Yeah. Despite the trouble Billy has caused, the chairman decides to show Billy the prize of the exhibit, the oldest sailing ship ever found, an original Viking boat deemed priceless. However, when they open the room containing it, it's completely gone, and yet again, Billy is blamed.
Okay, where did you put it?
I don't know.
You don't know? Well, I know something. I know you are an Ulysses fool.
That's jinx in Norwegian.
So determined to clear his name, Billy contacts Sporticus for help. Using the Lewsheimer plot helper computer, Billy and pals are able to find out that the ship was time warped back to 998 AD, the Age of Vikings, and it's up to Billy to get it back.
But be careful, one mistake back there and
ooh. Oh dear, I think Pandusa's meds just kicked in. So Billy and company travel back to 998, only to be captured by a Viking within a very short amount of time. Fortunately for Billy and friends, it's not just a Viking, but a Viking that's in possession of the ship they're looking for. He also seems to weirdly be the only Viking in the entire area somehow. How convenient.
Who are you? Eric the Red? Orloff the Orange? Croc the Green?
I'm Willy the Yellow.
No, this Viking is Victor the Violent, and he loves challenges, so Billy decides to use his wits to defeat Victor, and by wits, I mean he uses one of the oldest tricks in the book.
I say that I can break these ropes, and you can't.
You can break that rope, and I can't? You're wrong.
Okay, I can't break the ropes. In order to win the challenge, you have to prove that you can.
That's easy.
Thanks, Victor. I needed that.
I can't believe that worked. Then again, Victor has never seen a cartoon before, so I guess it's kind of fair that he fell for that. However, it seems Vanda was watching this somehow, and it makes her so mad they repeat the animation of her getting into the camera's face for the third time. The bird Poco volunteers Sipe to fix the issue, which Vanda agrees that Sipe better go back in time and stop Sport Billy from succeeding.
Send yourself back there and see to it Sport Billy and his friends don't return. Ever!
Instantly your universal yuckiness, but I think Poco should go with me.
Huh? Oh no!
Oh yes!
What the hell kind of delivery is that? I effing love it. Come on, let's see that part again. Sipe and Poco appear in the Viking Age, and Poco finds Billy and reveals his location to Victor.
Oh no!
Oh yes!
Oh yeah!
Yeah, I know, probably too soon to repeat that joke, but I couldn't resist it when the show sets it up so easily. Now that he's captured again, Billy makes a new challenge to Victor. This time the challenge is that if Billy can defeat him in his own Viking sport, Victor will let him and his friends go and take the Viking ship with them. Victor agrees, despite the fact I don't think he gets anything for beating Billy out of this. Guess he just likes challenges that much. Victor decides that him and Billy will do a best 2 out of 3 competition. The first sport is target shooting. Billy pulls out a magic bow and arrow from his omni-set. Wait a second. Victor doesn't get magic items. Doesn't this mean Billy's cheating? Fair play, mascot, my ass. Sipe tries to sabotage Billy by bending the arrow, but seemingly it's a magic homing arrow because Billy shoots it straight up in the air and it somehow corrects its bend and homes right in on the target. Seems Billy had won, but...
Amazing, but you missed.
What?
Yeah, the target's still there. No, it isn't. One for me.
Yep, these are Viking sports, all right. So next is the hammer toss. The longest throw wins, and Victor makes quite a good throw. However, Billy pulls out a pair of speed-boosting shoes to help him get some extra speed to throw the hammer further.
Is it the shoes?
Damn it, Billy. What happened to teaching Earth about fair play and good sportsmanship? You aren't relying on your own abilities. You're relying on unauthorized equipment. It's like having a boxer bring a gun to a boxing match. Victor is impressed with Billy's illegal maneuvers and says that they're even, with the next match determining the winner. That next match being rowing.
I can't win with these heavy old oars. But these new lightweight aluminum oars and a fast count stroke might just do it.
Jesus, I'm gross. What the hell? Less sports Billy and more like sports cheater. Sheesh. So Billy cheats to win and Victor congratulates Billy and lets him and his friends take the Viking ship.
You're a good sport, Victor.
Unlike you, Billy. Billy returns the boat to the museum and the chairman is extremely happy and calls Billy a hero. Then the episode ends with Billy and Lily giving us a very muddled lesson on good sportsmanship.
Poor Vanda. Being so evil, she just doesn't know what she's missing.
I kind of feel sorry for her too, Lily. She always loses.
And that was an episode of Sport Billy, and boy, that was a show, huh? The good sportsmanship angle of this show seems very confused, seeing as Billy actually cheated his way to victory here. But maybe the next episode we watch will do better, so let's take a look. So the episode starts with Billy and company on their way to Olympus, so Billy can officiate the annual Olympus Games.
After all, you are the best athlete.
I just do what comes naturally, I guess.
And by that, he means he cheats. What? I'm still salty about the last episode. Besides, that's not a very honest looking face if you ask me. Seems that children from all over the universe have been invited to the Olympus Games. All four of them. And one of those participants is Lily. However, it seems Lily participating in the event is part of Vanda's newest evil plan. A plan to use the event to discredit Lily. She would try discrediting Billy, but seems Billy isn't participating in the event since he is deemed Olympus' best athlete. I'd figure being Olympus' best athlete would be more reason for him to participate, but hey, I've never been good at sports myself, so what do I know? And in this scene, Billy's vibrator turned on while Sportacus was watching, but it's okay, Sportacus is into it. Seems Vanda has gotten herself a participant for the Olympus Games, Jane Jetson as a child. Okay, it's an earthling named Beth, but come on, she totally looks like a child version of Jane Jetson. However, it seems that Beth is not just a good athlete, but a complete bitch that loves deception, and is perfect for helping Vanda with her plan.
Beth has no qualms about cheating to win.
Oh, so she's like Sport Billy then. In order to make sure Beth succeeds at framing Lily, Vanda gives her the Nega Sack, an evil version of Billy's Omni Sack that only pulls out dirty tricks.
There's a girl after my own heart. Oh, she should have been born green.
Is that racist? I think that might be racist. So back on Olympus, Lily is getting some practice in before the events.
You can practice with my equipment.
Thanks, but this is all I need.
Oh, heck yeah. Lily ain't no rotten cheater like you, Billy. She knows what's up. Spartacus introduces Beth to Lily, explaining that she has just entered the competition today, somehow not thinking it's sus that another Earthling has gotten to Olympus.
Well, best of luck to you, Beth. Save the luck for yourself, Lily. I've got skill on my side.
Ah, yeah, Beth must be an American. While Billy wishes Lily luck at the next event, Beth sneaks in and switches out Lily's shoes. Fortunately for Beth, the Negasack is able to produce shoes that look exactly like Lily's. As Lily and Beth participate in the track event, Beth turns on the shoes that she gave Lily, causing Lily to run super fast and win the event.
The winner of the 400 meter run.
Sport Lily? Is Sport Billy's surname? Are they married? Wow, people really get married young these days. Wait a second, this was 1979. As Lily tries to rest from her victory, Beth reveals to the public that Lily's shoes had jets on them and that Lily had cheated and should be disqualified, much to the surprise of everyone. Though to be honest, you shouldn't be surprised, Billy. You would have done the same damn thing. Well, everyone on Olympus thinks Lily is a cheat, and she's been disqualified, and Beth has been determined the winner by default. Billy and Sportacus note how sus it was that Beth just happened to instantly know about the shoes and wish to question her more about the event. However, before they can, Beth teleports back to Vanda's ship, but accidentally leaves the Negasack, which Willy discovers and brings to everyone. Needless to say, everyone is surprised by Willy's big sack. Yeah, I know, that joke is childish, but it's hard to not make jokes like that when your character has a name that is literally a euphemism for penis. Billy examines the bag not only to find Lily's original shoes, but a variety of other dirty tricks, and comes to the conclusion that Beth must have been an agent for Vanda.
That figures. There's nothing she wouldn't try to spoil our Olympian Games.
Well, that, she's the only villain on this entire show. So Billy and friends decide to fly to Vandalusa so that they can find Beth and prove Lily's innocence. The kids find Beth and guilt trip her into being willing to admit her guilt to Olympus.
Beth,
Don't you see how wrong it is to blame someone else for your own mischief?
You may get away with it now, but someday you may find yourself in my position with someone putting the undeserved blame on you. I didn't mean to hurt anybody, honest.
Wow, she sure got convinced really easily. It's like someone just came in and turned off her bitch switch or something.
Here's your problem. Someone set this thing to evil.
Beth decides to go back to Olympus and take responsibility for what she did. But of course it can't be that easy because the writers realize that they still had at least 8 minutes of time to kill, and thus Sipe and the guards catch the kids and take them to Vanda. Beth tries to claim she had captured Billy and friends, but Billy gives her the old stink eye. I mean, seriously, look at Billy's face. He looks like he's gonna cut someone. So Beth cracks and tells Vanda the truth that she was going to confess her misdeeds to Olympus.
So you do have a conscience. Very commendable for an Earthling, but very stupid for us Vandalusians.
That's actually kind of an amusing amount of self-awareness for this show. Vanda throws the kids into a dungeon cell. Billy pulls out his Omnisac to save the day, but before he can use whatever plot device that would have came out of it, Vanda teleports the Omnisac away from him. Possibly one of the smartest things she's ever done in this entire show, even if I have no idea how she managed to do that, or when she magically got teleportation powers. Fortunately for everyone, Billy managed to bring the Negasac with him as well, so Billy and Beth decide to use the dirty tricks on Vanda.
Big headache for Vanda.
This show is a big headache for me. So Beth hits Vanda and Sipe with a glue bomb. Man, that's some wonky animation.
It looks like Vanda and Sipe are really stuck on each other.
Look, Lily, don't give DeviantArt any ideas, please. The kids use a bomb to escape the cells. Sipe escapes the glue and attempts to shoot the kids with Vanda's freeze ray, but due to his incompetence and the fact that he has the aiming abilities of a Star Wars stormtrooper, Sipe ends up shooting Vanda by mistake, allowing the kids to escape. So the kids return to Olympus and Spartacus informs them that due to Beth's confession, all accounts of cheating has been removed from Lily's record. Spartacus also says the judges have renamed Lily the winner of the 400 meter race. Wait a second, that's not fair either. I mean, sure, Lily was framed by Beth, but Lily still didn't win the race on her own abilities. If anything, shouldn't they have to redo the race or disqualify both of them? It's still not fair to let her be the winner, you know. Then again, Billy is considered their best athlete, so I guess it's just as fair as his victories in the previous episode. As for Beth, since she took the responsibility for her actions, Spartacus has decided to take her under his wing and train her in good sportsmanship. At least I hope that's what he's training her in. Queen Bandusa asks Billy what happened to Vanda, which he replies with,
"Let's just say we managed to put her latest evil plan on ice, ma'am.
And her as well."
Wow. Thanks for killing the joke there, Willie. The episode ends with Sipe desperately trying to break Vanda out of her frozen state and Vanda exhaustingly exclaiming,
"Why am I always surrounded by idiots?
I was frozen today!"
And thus ends another episode of Sport Billy, and you might be asking, is this show a catastrophe? And I would say, yeah, definitely. The show is just not good. Billy's voice actor is terrible. The writing and background music is kind of all over the place, and the animation is incredibly poor. With the usual constant recycling of animation you tend to get from these Filmation shows. With that said, I don't totally hate this show either. Don't get me wrong, it's not good at all, but there's a little bit of good old-fashioned Filmation cheesiness that allows you to get some enjoyment out of it. I mean, I think it's definitely safe to say I've seen far worse from Filmation. But overall, it's not particularly funny or good in any way other than maybe that so bad it's amusing level. But even then, I'd say there's a lot better things you can watch for that, like the Super Friends or He-Man. I don't know, I'll just give it a solid 2 out of 5 sports balls. If there's any question I do have, I wonder what happened to Sport Billy. Much to my surprise, the company Sport Billy Limited only went defunct a few years ago. I can only assume that eventually Billy just had to grow up and go from Sport Billy to Minimum Wage William. We'll be right back. So the first episode we look at starts on Vandalusa, where Swipe... Swiper, nice. Cyper, no siping.